Hey, it's Matt and Lizzie in the morning. And did you realize that people can listen to us anytime they want?
They can?
Nonstop if they wanted to.
No.
Yeah, it's Matt and Lizzie on demand. And it starts right now.
92 Moose, I love this latest song from Teddy Swims. It is called The Door. It's Matt and Lizzie in the morning. Jim!
My beep beep boo, I said my beep beep boo. I love Jim Brickman.
It is the Jim Brickman. Time for Lizzie's Daily.
Aww, if you're just tuning in, I use Jim Brickman now because he's an incredible pianist and it's called Lizzie's Daily Awe now. Anyway, this is really exciting. I love Disney World. I'm a huge Mickey fan. I think a lot of us are. And so is Ben Clark. He's a Disney super fan who was very large at one point. He couldn't fit on theme park rides. And because of that, he pushed himself to lose 230 pounds to not only ride the rides, but he always wanted to play Prince Charming in Disney World.
Oh, really? Like the character?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
And that's a big deal. When I was in college, I got the chance to audition to be a character, a performer in Disney World. And they put you through a lot. I did make it. I never went. But it is very tough to do that. So previously, he weighed 420 pounds.
Wow.
And he had a 50-inch waist. Ben traveled to Poland for gastric sleeve surgery back in October of 22. After being denied access to Disney World rides and he couldn't be a performer, he spent $6,300, including flight, medication, now to just be on the rides in Disney World.
Well, and also to prolong his life, I would imagine. There's a lot of benefits to that.
There's a huge benefit to that because he's going to live longer. He says, I'm a huge Disney nerd. He's 35 years old, and so the weight loss enabled him to return to the stage because he's a big Broadway guy.
Yeah.
He says, the weight loss has given me confidence. I would not have been able to do this before. The Disney people are thrilled for him and happy to welcome them.
I'm sure. Yeah, yeah.
So it's just one of those things where if you have a dream and there are certain things that are stopping you, if there's a standard around the dream and there are certain things that are stopping you from achieving that, you can still achieve it. It'll take time, but you can still achieve it. So that's what Benny did. And I wonder if there's a YouTube video. I want to see him singing on stage as Prince Charming.
Oh, I'm sure there is. Yeah,
that'd be really like cool this to see.
Yeah.
Anyway, there you go, my loves. That's your daily.
Good morning.
Actually, we should start this off by saying I am freaking out now, you guys, because this is an interview that I have waited for. Matt has waited for. The entire 92 Moose Nation has waited for since last time we interviewed her. American Idol contestant, Central Maine Idol winner, an all-around epic, incredible singer, and just an incredible human being, Julia Gagnon. Did I say it right, Julia? Is here in studios right now with her fiance Nate, both incredible musicians, and they're killing it right now. So let's get to that right away. How do you pronounce your last name?
So this is a very common question that I get all the time, including Ryan. Like he was very...
Ryan Seacrest. She means Ryan Seacrest. You're on a first basis right now because they're besties. Oh my god,
they're besties. I'm just here.
Oh, Nate and Ryan.
Yes. Oh yeah.
You got to FaceTime them?
Oh, that's cool.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. So I would say that the correct way to pronounce it French is Gagnon.
Gagnon.
The way that a Mainer might pronounce it, but still homage to the French, is Gagnon.
Gagnon. Okay.
And then my family and I have given up on that. So we pronounce it Gagnon.
Gagnon.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Thank gosh. I didn't mess it up that much, Matt.
And we have some questions from listeners this morning as well. Correct?
The first one is pretty easy. Everyone knows you sing, but what's your favorite song, not genre, song to sing?
Ooh, what's your song?
We put this out this week and questions came in.
Oh, cool.
This was a big question.
Sweet. My favorite song to sing is probably My Mind by Yebba.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Mm-hmm. That's awesome. Yeah. I would love to hear you sing that song sometime.
Yes.
How am I doing, Matt?
You're doing great. You're okay. Doing great.
Next question. What was your favorite part, favorite and worst part, almost like peak and pit of American Idol, your journey?
My favorite part was definitely the people.
Yeah.
I think specifically Abby and I's friendship was so palpable through the screen, but we literally had so much fun. Like none of that was really for show.
It was just, it was real. Yes.
It was just how we were.
Yeah. Were you guys roommates?
Yeah. We chose each other as roommates.
Okay.
Yeah.
And Abby won.
Yeah, she did.
Yes.
She did win.
That's awesome.
Yes. But yeah, I mean, it was just the people. We were all so close and none of it was fake and everybody was so great and unique in their own way.
Right.
The worst part for me, honestly, was probably picking songs. That was hard. That was really difficult.
Now, each week, is it up to you or do they give you like a list? Because
Yeah. So sometimes they give you a list, especially if it's themed. And I think that's mostly to like reel you in and be like, don't let your mind go here or here, right?
Okay.
Stick to the theme. But they're huge lists. And if there's no list, then you're kind of, I don't know, at the bane of your own imagination.
Right.
And when you're a singer, I think singers can specifically, any musician, honestly, any artist, when they're asked like, oh, what's your favorite song? Or, oh, sing something. Immediately everything goes out the window and you completely forget every song you've ever heard.
Absolutely.
And you get you just get really like random. I don't know. It was really hard to reel in the imagination.
And you know what else I find very amazing about this whole process is not only do you all have to choose songs, the band has to learn all these songs.
Yeah.
That has always been such an incredible thing that, you know, we see these amazing singers every single week and you guys are killing it
back there.
And I'm just kind of like watching the band and I'm like, they learned all of these songs in a week.
The American Idol house band.
Yeah.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Chris Pooley in the house band. And they're geniuses.
It's unbelievable.
They're geniuses.
I bet they can do anything.
They can.
How did it feel knowing that millions of people were watching you?
I don't think it.
Did you keep, was it in the frontal lobe
no.
or did you put it in a filing
it was suppressed,
cabinet?
Yes.
Yeah. Good. Yeah.
That means you're good at compartmentalizing. Yes. You put it away.
No, that was suppressed for me.
And how many times, because this is another, this sort of goes to the performance aspect. Like, you know, the band learns all these songs and they crush it. You guys are picking a song. 3 days later, you're on stage crushing it. How many times are you rehearsing this before you're on live television? Yeah. Because watching you on stage, watching you in that moment and with the band.
It's like you've done it a million times.
It was like you had been rehearsing for that moment for 5 years.
Well, that's
and it had only been days. What is the rehearsal? What's the preparation like for that moment? Because it comes off so flawlessly.
Mm-hmm. One unseen superpower behind American Idol is definitely the vocal coaches.
Okay.
You see them once in like one episode.
Right.
And it makes it, no, we're working with them like
constantly.
All the time, especially when it gets into the lives. And my vocal coaches, Nikki and Mike, were with me through all of it, or most of it, after Hawaii. They were mine. They were assigned me and I was assigned them. And I rehearsed with them, like they would help you, like, what song are you thinking? What do you think for this arrangement? We don't want to make it karaoke. How are you going to make it you?
Right.
And all that stuff.
Right.
Working with that, like for a week or so.
Wow.
You rehearse with the band 3 to 5 times.
Okay.
Before.
Still not a huge number of rehearsals considering the caliber of the performances that comes out of that.
How about this? Since we all love and we're all kind of like low-key voyeurs because we're online watching people all the time. Give us just a quick day in the life when you were in it, when you were in the thick of it. You wake up, you're with your roommate, Abby, now winner of American Idol.
Love her.
Yep. Okay. And then what do? Do you go get breakfast? Do you jump around? Do you freak out? Oh my God. Do you do some yoga? And then like, what's your day like? What's that schedule look like behind the scenes?
When you're up at 4 or 5.
Okay.
Because I'll go a rehearsal day and a show day. So the rehearsal day.
This is so cool.
You're up at 6. Maybe 7.
Yeah.
The call times are no later than 8 for adults. Minors had later times.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. Because there were people under 18.
That was good. But they had to do school. So I'm not jealous.
Right.
They get us all in a van and they bring us to the studio where we would rehearse, do photos, choreography, sometimes stage, but not usually wardrobe.
I was going to say, did you guys get like hair and makeup provided?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And so you would go, and it really depended. They wouldn't tell you the schedule, mostly, I think, to keep us all, like, sane, because there might be a day where I was not scheduled to do anything.
Right.
But they might be ahead, or something might change. Somebody, sure. You know, but they had to have us all there, so we don't know our schedule at all.
Right.
We would rehearse, and they would provide us with meals, but it was a lot of sitting around.
Right.
Yeah.
And jamming.
Hurry up and wait.
And thinking. And I think the biggest time spend was wardrobe, because they wanted to make sure that you were comfortable.
Right.
I personally wasn't ever, because, like, my style isn't a big bedazzled stage.
Yeah, right.
There was
right.
no way, but that was like a battle that they couldn't win with
right.
me. Like, there was no way to make me comfortable, so they did their best.
Right.
Yeah.
So that included, like, trying on a lot of stuff.
Sure.
Of course.
And being.
And that,
like,
took time.
Which one do you like the most, even though we know you don't really like any of them?
Yeah.
So that would probably take 3 hours in itself.
Right.
Multiple days, because they tailor it to you
wow.
after. And I'm short.
What so a production.
I always had to have it tailored. I was always in order.
Same girl.
Yeah.
It's amazing, because, like, when you're talking about the stuff that's on the scene, it's amazing the hours, the days
yeah.
that go into all of this. And what America sees is one finely tuned yeah. hour.
No,
you know,
we worked really hard.
Yeah.
Really, really hard. We got 2 days off within 2.5 months.
Jesus. Wow, yes. That's incredible.
And you traveled. You went down yes. to Disney.
Yeah.
And Hawaii? Was it? Or,
yeah, Hawaii. Yeah. I didn't go to Disney.
Okay.
That was they went to Disney.
They went to Disney.
Yep. We went to Disneyland just for fun. But
okay, that's maybe how I thought you went to
yeah,
Disney.
Yeah,
okay,
oh, cool. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, no. And your minimum working at least 8 hours.
Yeah.
Every day, even if they don't need you.
That's incredible.
Yeah, it's a lot of hours, and I mean, they did their best to organize it. I can't.
Yeah.
I'm not jealous of the team at all.
I mean, they've been right. doing it for a yeah. while. So
yeah, for yeah. sure.
It's
yeah.
probably not super fine tuned, but almost. Now,
right.
there was one point where you had put out a video. Obviously, with fame comes a lot of eyes and a lot of opinions.
Uh-huh.
And on this show, Matt and I really like to talk, especially to the young people, and about the impact on bullies
yeah.
and how hopefully that's kind of going away. I'm hoping it'll be gone within the next few years.
Was this a video you had posted with Abby?
No, she did one alone.
I thought there was.
Oh,
and
oh,
you were just
I know which one you're talking about. Yeah.
You know, the bullying and negative words online and,
yeah.
and how they affect you and impact you. And I, like I just said, I'm hoping that bullying is going to be going away soon for good, because it's uh-huh. so stupid.
Yeah.
It doesn't make any sense anymore. We're all over it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But you really struck a nerve for me and a lot of people when you put out that video. Can you talk on that just a
yeah.
little bit, or how that,
yeah.
how you're doing with that?
I think I put out two videos where I was more serious about hate, because Abby and I did do funny videos, and that was
yeah.
all, like, it didn't, we were in the place to do that.
Yeah.
So, I mean, there's a reason that not all the contestants did that, and we were super, I think, in touch with the fact that we were really lucky to be able to laugh at it.
Amazing.
And yet, nobody should be expected to be able to laugh at it.
No.
Because
right.
it's not funny.
No.
If you don't make it funny.
Right.
Right.
And I think I honestly made one video because, a specific contestant, or a few, honestly, were getting attacked, for consistently making it through.
Okay.
And to have people bash somebody else for their success in the competition, even if it's in your name, right?
Yeah.
Even if it was in, like, she should have made it over you, or he should have made it instead of them.
Right.
It was not something that I was willing to put my name at the very least behind it.
Right.
And I think what I basically called for was, even if you're supporting, just support me. And
right.
if you want to support me by bringing somebody else down, I don't want that type of support.
Yeah.
Because I know what it's like, and we all got a taste of it. Like, you shouldn't be there and they should be there. And it really, takes away from kind of like what we discussed previous, is all the work that we did.
Absolutely.
We don't just stumble out on stage and everybody there put their hearts and souls and mental health
right.
on the line for that show.
Yeah.
And to not give up. And it was frustrating to see people start to question, oh, do I really want to do this anymore?
Right.
Because
of that.
You know, people
because
clearly don't want me here. And it's like, no,
Yeah.
People clearly are just frustrated by the fact that their favorite didn't make it this far. I mean, it happened with me when I was eliminated.
And there's a good example of this would be like, you know, when you were eliminated, all of us were like, she shouldn't have been eliminated. Julia should have won this. Right. But that's different than saying Julia shouldn't have been eliminated. She should have been there instead of X, right. Y, Z.
Exactly.
And that right there is the problem.
It is.
You know, everyone deserved to be there, especially when you were getting into the top 20, top 10. I mean, you guys were all incredible. There wasn't a single vocalist on that show at that point that wasn't excellent.
Yeah.
You know, and of course we have our favorites, obviously, but you can have your favorites without being a douchebag.
Yeah, exactly.
92
Mid-Coast Energy.
Nami Timu, Central Maine's number one hit music station. Matt and Lizzie, we are live. It's another Monday, live from the Damon's Beverage Studios. And Lizzie and I didn't get to wish all the dads out there a happy Father's Day yesterday because we weren't here.
Yeah.
But I always love Father's Day because, well, I'm a father and it's my day.
Happy Father's Day, Daddy.
Thank you. Way of putting it. Got all my gifts. Of course, Gavin and Dawson. At their age, you know, they make the handmade gifts at school and daycare. And those are so precious. And I got my new coffee mug with Dawson's face on it.
Mm.
And Gavin made me a couple crafts. Evan got me a new leather wallet and a wonderful card. And my wife, Carrie, who is arguably the best gift giver of our time. If you are ever stuck and you're like, I don't know what to do, message her for ideas. She is... I always thought I was a pretty good gift giver, but she just is ridiculous.
Yeah.
She gave me a gift bag yesterday and I'm opening it up and what I'm looking at inside, I'm like, I think this might be a blanket. It looks like a flannel blanket.
Mm-hmm.
And actually I have a picture I can show you here in just a moment, but it was not a blanket. I pulled it out and opened it up. It was actually a wool lined flannel with a hood. Harley Davidson button up jacket.
Wow.
That sounds
fancy.
That's the front of it.
Matt,
yeah,
that
I know.
Looks fantastic on you.
Thank you.
It's a white and black checkered flannel with a black hood.
And it has
and
the Harley skull.
Harley Davidson emblem on the back with a skull. That looks very nice on you.
I appreciate that. She's like, hopefully you like this. And I was like,
fits like it was made for you.
I said, this is what I would have bought out of all. And I wasn't even at the store with her. She bought it at North Country Harley, of course. And, I would have picked this out. This is an amazing gift. And of course, yesterday afternoon, Carrie and I went out on the bike for an hour or so because, Carrie's father passed away in 06 and she wanted to go visit him, at the cemetery in Augusta where I actually have a lot of family buried as well. So we took an hour out of the day yesterday, rode the bike to Augusta to go visit with our past loved ones.
Yeah.
And I was like, I have to wear my new thing.
Yeah,
I have to wear my new
them.
Jacket.
Yeah, show them.
You know,
show
I want to try it out. Even in the wind, riding 50, 60 miles an hour yesterday, by the time we got to the cemetery in Augusta, my forearms were sweating.
Oh,
that's
good.
How warm it was.
Good.
I was like, this is insane.
Yeah.
That's
fantastic.
I'll be able to ride in January.
Good. So. I'm glad. Yesterday we went to Mechanic Falls and tried out
Janelle's parents?
Dad. Yes.
Okay, yep.
Janelle's dad's new pizza oven that we all chipped in to buy for him.
Is this one of those wood-fired ones or is it propane-fired?
Both.
Oh, it's a dual fuel.
Yes.
Dual fuel.
It's an Ooni. O-O-N-I.
Oh, yeah. Wicked cool.
We make the dough. Well, Janelle is in charge of that because she's the pizza maker. Because she works at Bates and she does the brick oven. So she knows all about it. Don't use flour. Use the other stuff because you can taste it. Anyway, she's awesome. She's making the dough. He literally puts it in this Ooni for 3 seconds. It was seconds until the pizza was done.
It's crazy.
And it was
because they cook
delish.
It like 900 degrees or something.
Yeah, it was. He tested it because he has a little thing.
Of course he does, yeah.
And he tested it and all it said was high. It was very hot. It was delicious. But that's how we spent our daddy's day with Janelle's dad, who is wonderful. I wrote an article about him once shooting with what are the things that go like this?
Bow and arrow.
No. The little things, like when you're a kid, they're shaped
slingshot.
In a...
Slingshot.
He made this cool slingshot to shoot at his squirrel.
Is that the one he shoots the squirrels with?
From his window in his bathrobe. It's hilarious. So happy Father's Day to all the daddies.
Happy Father's Day. And I can only say that a real man getting a pizza oven for Father's Day must be like a me getting a family-sized air fryer.
That's right.
Starting.